trucks, trucks, and more trucks. It seems like with Whistlin' Diesel doing his thing, and heck, the fact that the most popular vehicle in the USA is a truck, the Ford F-150, trucks recently have been making a huge come up. And so, if you're looking for one that is badass, dependable, and rugged, and oh yeah, affordable, you've come to the right place. We're gonna break down seven trucks that look like they should cost six figures, but they won't break the bank at all. And if you're new here, please subscribe and turn on that notification bell and buckle up, and let's go. And a way to start off this list with a Cadillac Escalade, a staple among rich suburban soccer moms, Secret Service agents, and famous rappers. But did you know that they actually made a pickup version of the Escalade? Yeah, that's right. I'm talking about the EXT, baby. And that's not to be confused with the Cadillac Escalade ESV, which is the stretched out version of the Escalade SUV. See, the EXT is essentially a normal Escalade with its third row chop and then a truck bed put in its place. And the EXT is actually heavier than the standard Escalade. And so because of its weight, it's not required to have EPA fuel economy ratings. So just imagine going to buy a truck and asking what fuel economy it gets, just get it blown off because the manufacturer doesn't have to provide it. That's slightly concerning. However, consumers have reported between 14 and 17 miles per gallon, which is pretty much on par with the standard Escalade SUV. But what it doesn't share with its SUV brother, it's midgate. Huh? A midgate? Oh yeah, it's an interior-exterior pass-through, which is actually pretty genius because it lets you extend the short little bed into an 8-foot aircraft carrier, which I bet comes in handy quite a bit. Now the EXT is powered by that 6.2-liter V8 pumping out 400 horsepower, and these things are reliable, easily reaching 200,000 miles and beyond. And that 400 horsepower and 400 foot-pounds of torque means that this truck has a ton of grunt, and all you gotta do is slap on an exhaust system, and this beast sounds amazing. I was not expecting that. That sounded great. So it's luxurious and it looks like $1 million, not to mention it's less than 10 grand. Sign me up. And real quick, if you're enjoying this video so far, please hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm. We're looking to get 17,896 likes, which is about as many people that like this next brand and this next truck, because it'll go 300,000 miles without a sweat. Yeah, we're talking about a Toyota. And the Toyota Tacoma definitely has huge aftermarket support, so you can really make it your own. And a ton of people do. You got lift, wheels, tires, you name it. The aftermarket is there for the Tacoma. And since it's a mid-sized truck, most parts are cheap and they'll last the life of the truck, which is a long time because after all, it is a Toyota. And Toyota has made the Tacoma in a ton of configurations, from the regular single cab, to the access cab, to the double cab. And all are offered in long or short bed and rear or all-wheel drive. And it also comes in a manual transmission, baby. So if you wanna help save the manuals, go snag this ideal T. And while the newer Tacomas may not be as robust as the older generations, they have made some sacrifices to modernize it. You know, things like modern navigation, power windows, a more powerful but less durable V6 that might not survive being blown off a building. Yeah, that one was pretty much indestructible. And that being said, I still would probably take a newer model because the engines on the older Tacos are super reliable, but they're not the most economical. However, any Tacoma is gonna be super capable. And I don't know if you knew this, but Arctic Trucks Iceland even converted a Tacoma and sent it to the South Pole, which only took 16 hours. Yeah, the thing was littered in mods. But it definitely says something that they chose the Tacoma as the platform for this project. And at auction, that vehicle fetched $53,000, which yes, is a lot of dough. And if you don't like that price, you can get one with roughly 150,000 miles, add a lift kit, wheels and tires, and for less than 15 grand, you're gonna look real good. And while the Tacoma is definitely one of the most capable trucks out there, the next truck just might give it a run for its money because it's the most sold vehicle in America. You see, the F-150 outsells the Toyota Camry in the US. And if that stat doesn't blow your mind, well, then you probably live in San Francisco or like New York because, well, trucks don't really do that well in the city. But everywhere else in this world, and especially in the USA, the Ford F-150 is king. And because there are so many examples made and sold every single year, there is a lot of used examples available for you. And so that's why their prices continue to fall extremely low for what you get. And so that's great news if you're in the market because you get a ton of truck for the money. And if you want leather and a locking diff, get an F-150 because you're gonna be able to haul and carry 5 adults. And if you wanna learn about the baddest and best F-150s ever made, go watch this ideal vid. Because yes, F-150s are just pure American badassery. And they're offered in all different flavor of engines, from a twin turbo V6, which puts out more power than most sports cars, and yet it still returns over 20 miles per gallon, which is kind of mind blowing considering that that truck is so big. Or you could opt for the Mustang motor. You heard me right. They offer a 5-liter Coyote motor from the Mustang GT in the F-150. Build it up to 1,000 horsepower, and you'll have yourself a pretty awesome sleeper truck. Unfortunately, this one for under 9 grand doesn't come with the Coyote, but I think we can all agree that is a serious bargain and punches way above its weight. And if you got a little dough left over after you buy an F-150, you could either throw that into downpipes and tune it if it's an EcoBoost for over 500 horsepower, or if it is a Coyote, just throw a turbo on there and you will blow some serious muscle. But the F-150 isn't the only truck on this list that loves boost. Say hello to the GMC Sierra Denali. This thing is powered by a 6.2 liter V8 churning out over 400 horsepower. And this truck means business. And it sure as hell looks like it too. The Sierra is way more luxurious than the Tacoma or even the F-150. And that Denali package is the cherry on top because it takes it up another notch. I'm talking face chrome styling, bigger wheels, and of course that big bad V8. And the Denali package is really all about the interior, lined in leather throughout and loaded with wood trim. It's like as if Mercedes turned the S-Class into a truck. But just like an S-Class, the Sierra Denali looks way more expensive than it is. It starts at roughly 45 grand, and I'd have to say new, that's a pretty good deal. But today, thanks to depreciation, you could have a beautiful maroon Sierra Denali for less than 14 grand. And I bet if you use the Ideal Car strategies and you learned how to buy it like a pro, you could get it for closer to 10. Not bad, huh? Well, maybe the Denali doesn't have enough flavor for you. Well, then you gotta check out the Dodge Ram 1500 Laramie Longhorn, because this truck is built for back roads and barbecue. It's pretty much made for those people that want a taste of ranch in their truck. See what I did there? No, you're right, no one likes condiments spilling on their seats. But the Ram 1500, it brings a little cowboy into the cabin with saddlebags on the back of the front seats. And sure, they're not as big as real saddlebags, but it definitely gives you that Longhorn feel. The interior is sprinkled with black burled wood for even more country vibes. And that exterior, it's got its fair share of chrome and aluminum, and that makes it easily distinguishable from the lower tier models in the lineup. Oh, and it's got beige lower body cladding. Why? Because, well, why not? All these features add up to make the Laramie Longhorn basically the truck version of John Wayne. And how much you ask? Well, less than 15 grand. But hey, maybe you're not all about that cowboy life. That's okay, because we got a super luxurious truck up next from a pretty unexpected maker. Wait, what? A Lincoln truck? Wasn't it called the Blackwood? Well, actually, the Mark LT is the successor of the Blackwood's legacy. And it actually has a truck bed instead of a trunk. But hold on, isn't the Mark LT just an F-150? Well, it's got different badges and different wheels, but I think us auto enthusiasts know better than to be fooled by that. And that being said, the average person is going to assume it's a way classier, way more expensive model than the F-150. Even though it's powered by the exact same 5.4 liter V8 that Ford put in pretty much every single vehicle that they sold, like ever. And that actually is a good thing because it's not only reliable, but it's also cheap to fix. The problem is the Mark LT didn't sell all that well. In 5 years of its production, they only produced about 35,000 of them. So they're kind of rare. And rare means expensive, right? Well, not in the Mark LT's case, because you could have one of these glorified F-150s for less than 8 grand, which is a deal, especially when everyone's gonna think that you paid way more. But if flashy isn't quite your style, and if you want something just a tad more blue collar and you're looking Chevy, definitely gotta look at the Silverado. The Silverado is made for the everyday working man. Sometimes you gotta pull a stump out of the ground or haul your boat to the lake. The Silverado's got all the grit you need, baby. And you can get one with an LS-based V8 that gives you almost 400 horsepower and over 10,000 pounds of pulling power. Or if you prefer a little bit more fuel economy, you can opt for a wimpier V6 that gets 20 miles to the gallon. Your call, partner. Now that's not the only thing you get to choose with the Silverado. Oh no. You got 5 suspension choices, from off-road to pavement only. The Silverado can be whatever you want it to be. People are even taking Silverados and turning them into badass race trucks with just some aftermarket mods, or complete off-road beasts like this one for less than 12K, with room to haul the whole family and the boat. So if I had to pick which one I would get, well, it'd have to be that Cadillac Escalade EXT, or maybe the Lincoln. I don't know, probably the Cadillac. What one would you choose? Let us know down below. And also, if you enjoyed the vid, hit the like button. And if you're new here, please subscribe, turn on that notification bell. This is Ideal. I hope that you find your ideal truck and keep living the ideal lifestyle.